WDSU first warning weather. We're tracking some pretty hefty storms this evening, and the heftiest storms now moving into some areas. If these hold, they'll be into the North Shore before you know it. Poplarville getting some pretty hefty rain here. Rollins, Barth, Crane Creek, Leetown getting some pretty hefty storm activity. Got one that's right on the state line. We've got some storms pushing out of St. James Parish. We've got Baton Rouge and region, Belle Alliance, Donaldsonville here, and some really hefty storms technically just outside of our viewing area that has been designated. But look at this, Franklin gets some really hefty rain outside of Morgan City, but really Franklin, that's where the heftiest storms are at this time. So we've got a lot to cover here. We're going to jump right into the tropics now that we've done radar. We're going to cover the temperatures really quick though. Topped out at 96 today, Lakefront did 95, 97 officially at Bogalusa in our state's capital. We got some rain cooled air in some cases, but Lakefront's still feeling like 105 tomorrow. Heat advisory kicks in. It's going to be a WDSU first warning weather impact day. Coast is not included, or coastal Mississippi either. Everybody else is. So we're tracking Hurricane Erin. Hurricane Erin over the weekend from Friday night. And I last spoke with you on Saturday morning. This was a monster category 5, winds 140, northwest at 10. You can see that we've tried to do another eyewall replacement recently, lashing the Turks and Caicos, the Bahamas right now. Tropical storm alerts that are up, tropical storm warnings, tropical storm watches. But now for the Outer Banks of North Carolina, we also have tropical storm watches that are up and storm surge watches here too. The reason for this is because this storm is really going to pack the punch. It's so large in size here. You watch the track that this will be taking through the Atlantic. Look how hefty and expansive this is. So we could have wind gusts well over 40, 45 miles per hour, which is why the tropical storm watches. It won't be hurricane force winds, but we could have a lot of storm surge and, of course, those gusty winds that we just showed. There's a look at Doppler radar really quick, but back to the watch, storm surge watch that'll be here too. You can see that's in the purple, and from there we go. We'll head back to what we're watching, a wave, a tropical wave here too. But first, the latest track here, still maintaining a major category 3 status all the way until the end of the week. There it is, Wednesday night to Thursday. You could have the big impacts on North Carolina, not until a category 1 until we get over the weekend. But as we're tracking this tropical wave as well, another system that is way out, Cabo Verde Islands, chance of development here over the next 3 to 7 days. Water temps just marginally stable enough to do that. We're comparing the forecast out of the U.S. and the forecast out of Europe here. Very similar forecast by Thursday that you can see as we're entering the Lesser Antilles. Placements are still pretty similar, but we start to get the forecast differing a bit when we get into the weekend. Forecast out of the U.S. more to the greater Antilles, Bahamas, and then the forecast out of Europe wanting to take more of a track where Erin took it off the coast. So we'll be monitoring that really closely. Widely scattered storms tomorrow, give it a 40% chance. Temperatures right around 95, 96, maybe 92 to 93, feeling like 107, 108. And that's the WDSU first warning weather impact day for the heat advisory that kicks in. We'll do the same thing Wednesday. I'll be interested to see if another advisory is issued. If it is, we'll make it an impact day. Increase in storm coverage will take temperatures down a notch or two by the end of the week.